students, welcome back to the next module of our chapter called Electrostatics. Now students, in this particular module, we'll be focusing on types of capacitor. At the same time, we'll be also learning uses of capacitors, right? So let us start with the module. Now students, when I say types of capacitor, based on the shape, capacitors are classified into three categories, or I can say based on the shape, the capacitors are of three types. Now, first type of capacitor is parallel plate capacitor. Second type of capacitor is cylindrical capacitor. And third type of capacitor is spherical capacitor, right? So let us start with the first type of capacitor, which says parallel plate capacitor. Now students, we have already learned this particular type of capacitor. Now you know that this particular capacitor consists of two parallel plates which are insulated. So let's say I'm having plate P1 and let's say we are having plate P2. Both of them are parallel and they are separated by finite distance small d, right? Now students, in this case of capacitor, one of the plate is positively charged and the other plate is earth connected. So let's say I'm having plate P1 which is positively charged, and let's say the outer surface of this plate P2 is connected to ground or it is connected to earth, right? Now, due to this particular assembly, the inner surface of plate P2 will acquire negative charge. Now, see the diagram carefully. The inner surface is acquiring negative charge. Now, you can see carefully, there is a space which is present between plates P1 and P2. And this particular space between plates P1 and P2 is filled with the dielectric medium, which is having dielectric constant K. Right? See the diagram? So we are having plates P1, P2, P1 positively charged, the outer surface of P2 connected to ground, inner surface acquires negative charge, and the space is filled with the dielectric medium having dielectric constant K. Right? So this was about parallel plate capacitor. Now let us move towards the second type of capacitor, which is cylindrical capacitor. Right? Now students, when I say cylindrical capacitor, it consists of two coaxial cylinders having radius small a and radius small b. Now see the diagram carefully. Here we are having two coaxial cylinders. The inner cylinder is having radius small a. See the diagram. And the outer cylinder is having radius small b. See the diagram carefully. Right? Now listen to this very carefully. The outer surface of inner cylinder. What did I say? The outer surface of inner cylinder is positively charged. See the diagram? This particular surface is positively charged. Because of this, the inner surface of outer cylinder, see the diagram? This particular surface acquires negative charge. And the outer surface of outer cylinder is connected to earth, right? The outer surface, it is connected to earth. So what we have said, learned up till now? The cylindrical capacitor consists of two coaxial cylinders. Inner cylinder having radius small a, outer cylinder having radius small b. Then the outer surface of inner cylinder is positively charged, because of which inner surface of outer cylinder acquires negative charge, and the outer surface of outer cylinder is connected to earth. Now, as you can see in the diagram, there is a space which is present between two cylinders. This space is filled with the dielectric medium, which is having permittivity epsilon, or which is having dielectric constant K. So this was about second type of capacitor, which is nothing but your cylindrical capacitor. Now let us move towards third type of capacitor, which is nothing but spherical capacitor. Now when I say spherical capacitor, it consists of two concentric spheres, right? See the diagram carefully. Here we are having two concentric spheres. The inner sphere is having radius small a, and the outer sphere is having radius small b, right? Now listen to this very carefully. The outer surface of inner sphere is positively charged. Now see the diagram. This surface is positively charged. Because of this, the inner surface of outer sphere acquires negative charge. Now see the diagram carefully. There we have negative charge, and the outer surface of outer sphere is connected to earth. Now see the diagram carefully again. This particular surface is connected to ground. Now again, as you can see, there is a space which is present between two spheres, and in this particular space, dielectric medium which is having permittivity epsilon or dielectric constant K is present between the two spheres. Now see the diagram. Here we are having dielectric medium which is present, right? So students, up till now we have learned three types of capacitor. First one was parallel plate capacitor. Second one was cylindrical capacitor. And third one was spherical capacitor. Now let us move towards the uses of capacitor. Right? Now, first important use is it is basically used in the tuning of radio circuit. Second important use is it is used to store large amount of charge, which is basically used in nuclear reactor, right? And third one, it is very important, it is used to eliminate sparking points, right? When they are open or closed in the ignition system of any automobile engine, right? And the last but not least, it is used for the smoothing of rectified current in the power supplies, right? So all these uses are very important. Please note it down properly. So students, in this particular module, we have learned about types of capacitor. At the same time, we have also learned uses of capacitors. So that's it for this particular module. I'll see you in the next module. Till then, keep learning.